YouTube. In this video tutorial I will show how to program an Arduino to drive an a 28BIYJ 5V DC step motor using the ULN2003 direct on the array chip. This motor is a unipolar motor, a unipolar step motor, and let's see how we can drive that motor. I am at the Wikipedia article for the step motors. The first way that we can drive that motor is the weight drive. Here are the pulses that must be sent to the motor to start rotating. The A stands for the first phase, the B for the second phase, the C for the third phase, and the D for the fourth phase. So when the first phase pulse ends, the second phase pulse must begin. When the second phase pulse ends, the third phase pulse must begin. And when the third phase pulse ends, the fourth phase pulse must begin. And when the fourth phase pulse ends, the first phase pulse must begin. That is what telling us as that diagram. And when we have that sequence, the motor will rotate at the forward direction. But if the A stands for the fourth phase, the B for the third, the C for the second, and the D for the first phase, the motor will rotate at the reverse direction. Let's see our code. Let's see our function. The zero step is how we create that pulse. And so at the first step, excuse me for that, it may be a little bit confusing. So the first step for the wave stepping is that pulse, which is high, only the first phase. So then we go to the first step is that the phase 2 is high and the other are low. Then go to the second step, that is that step that only the third phase is high and the other are low. And the third step is the final step, that the phase 4 is high and the other phases are low. And we have here two functions, the wave step forward and the wave step reverse. And so if you want to drive the motor at the forward direction, which begin from the zero and we head to the third phase, from the zero step and we end to the third step. And if we want to rotate the motor at the reverse direction, we begin at the third step and we finish at the zero step. This is the delay, is the period. The period is the time of that pulse, the time interval between here and here. And if we have that time is actually, if that time is while we decrease that time, the motor will run faster. And if we increase that time, the motor will run slower. Let's see what I mean using my example. So my code goal is to drive a motor, for a full revolution at the forward direction, to stop 1.5 second, then drive the motor a full revolution at the reverse direction, and then stop again for 1.5 second, and that will be again and again and again. So the motor have 512 steps for one full revolution. and the pulse period is equal to 8 milliseconds, and the motor runs at that speed. Actually, it's a low speed. If the that time will be 10, 20, whatever, the motor will run slower, and the motor run at the both directions. And if I decrease that time, let's say to 5, the motor will run faster and faster. Let's see, the motor run faster than before at the both directions. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Until then, bye.